You know, while I was in Europe, whether it was in Paris at a fashion show or walking down the streets of the Champs-Élysées, you know, I was able to admire the beautiful people wearing incredible fashions, thanks to the model vision, you know, because only in Europe people would know what fashion is all about. Not in the United States. People wear polyester suits like that.
Here, hold this just a second.
What are you gonna do? How would you know about haute couture, Gino Colin? Well, you know, a man who doesn't wear socks, how would you know about class?
Did you say au toilet?
You know, talking about the powerful fragrance of arrogance, you know, there's something more important, that is vision. Yes, to be able to take a close look at beauty, a beautiful face, beautiful clothes, and beautiful body. Of course, I was looking into a mirror, looking at myself. And you know, talking about that, I can smell a really unpleasant odor here. So, excuse me, I must leave.
Huh. Give me a break.
I wonder how you would look, Rain. The lens of model vision.
Oh, boss man's mother has a nice cologne.
Stop it.
Ever hear of Liquid Wrench?
Time is Rhythm and Blues, and I have it on good authority that Bobby the Brain Heenan is now negotiating to have Mr. Perfect join forces with Rhythm and Blues. It'll be the first time in the history of the World Wrestling Federation that three former ex-Intercontinental champions six-man tag team.
You love saying former.
X sounds so permanent, doesn't it?
I was just on the phone with the Hammer. He doesn't want you to refer to him anymore.
Boxcar.
Boxcar.
He must have called collect that cheapskate. Coming up right now, Rhythm and Blues, let's take a look.
This tag team contest is scheduled for one fall.
It's not exactly to my right, like the entrance of Elvis. Of we're going to get awfully close here.
Well, I think Elvis would be a little envious of the Rhythm and Blues pairing.
Don't you think so?
Yes, I'm
now,
sure.
Ladies
he would.
And
now, for their musical talents
the
or their ring
the
talents?
Well,
look at Jimmy Hart. He's holding a platinum award there, a platinum record.
You know, I am so happy to announce that Rhythm and Blues' brand new album, A Honka 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 Honky Love, has just sold 5 million copies.
Where did he come up with all that money to buy that many records?
Which is a platinum record album, baby,
you don't
in the record
him, huh?
business, in case you don't know. And it's because of all of you lovely, wonderful people out there. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please get up off your seats, put your hands together, and welcome the greatest tag team ever assembled, Rhythm and Blues!
Well, here we go. Rhythm and Blues, the Honky Tonk Band, and Greg the Hammer Valentine.
What do you think that make out for the sale of 5 million of those records?
Depends what they were selling them for. $1.50 is not going to bring home much. Well, 5 million.
5 million. Well, actually, 7.5 million.
At $1.50.
But look at these people. They really like those two. I told you, Sean. They recognize their talents. And as I said before, Elvis Presley may have been a little envious of these two. They combine musical talents along with their wrestling talents.
Thank you very much.
Have you ever heard the entire album? What other songs are on the album?
No, I haven't listened to it, quite honestly.
Peggy Sue's Making Me Blue?
It's not my type of music.
No? The Honky Tonk Band, thankfully, has stopped singing and gotten down to business here. Drop toe hold there as Greg the Hammer Valentine comes in. Oh. And Valentine now goes to work on Jim McPherson. Another close-up look at the platinum record, but Alfred, these days, the Honky Tonk Band of Greg the Hammer Valentine have championship gold on their minds. Standing by, the new tag team champions, the Hart Foundation.
Hey, Rhythm and Blues, when the Hart Foundation says we're gonna do something, we do it. Right, Anvil? Right! Rhythm and Blues, you can bring your guitars! You can bring your hit albums!
You can bring the big mouth manager with you, but the pink and black attack is back, baby.
We like where we're at.
The Hart Foundation more than willing to accept this challenge. You know, Alfred, I have to admit, it's some matchup. Now, you consider that the Honky Tonk Man and Greg the Hammer Valentine are both former Intercontinental Champions. And also, the Hart Foundation was at one time managed by Jimmy Hart.
Yes,
got a lot going for them.
That could be the catalyst for their success. They have Jimmy Hart on their side, and the Harts don't. The Harts are great, great champions. Make no mistake about that. Probably the best tag team champions we've ever had. But Honky Tonk and Hammer, they have Jimmy Hart in their corner. Oh, what a tremendous move.
What do they call that move, Alfred?
Well, that's a double back suplex.
Oh, there's no musical rhyme to that, huh? The Honky Tonk Man and Greg the Hammer Valentine taking care of Jim McPherson and Mark Thomas. And they're going to celebrate with a little tune here. But they're really thinking about the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship, Alfred.
Well, let's see exactly how they accomplished that victory in the beginning. There is a great double back elbow, followed by this double back suplex. And the Honky Tonk and the Hammer, Greg Valentine, bring their mixture of melody and mayhem to the ring.
Now we're getting the live version here. Version with the Honky Tonk Man and Greg the Hammer Valentine of Hunka, 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 Honky Love. Got a gold record, a platinum record. But now they want the championship gold of the tag team ranks here in the WWF. They're on their way.
Are you quite... Boy, it doesn't take much to entertain you, does it?
It's in your blood when you hear
that
song.
I'll give credit where credit is due, especially to the Honky Tonk Man. To take a look around that jam-packed arena and see 90% or more of the people booing and thumbs downing you and say, thank you very much, your lovely audience. That takes a lot of guts to do that.
Well, I think what he's doing is Honky Tonk is thanking the people that do like him. The ones that don't like him.
And Boxcar, he don't even know what day of the week it is.
Greg the Hammer, not Boxcar. Please. You know, they have an advantage. Both former Intercontinental Champions. Greg the Hammer at one time was a World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion, one half.
You should Jimmy know a Hart lot about managed. Former Intercontinental Champions. I know you do. So I'm sorry I interrupted. Go ahead. I hit the vein, I guess, folks. We'll be back with our feature in just a moment.
Tuck it, excuse me, right into the front there, and all of a sudden you almost have like a turtleneck look up top.
Pretty.
Frames the face, and look at how it brings the whole outfit together.
And that allows a woman, again, to enjoy having a fashionable color like a burgundy or a gray, and still enhancing her best colors by putting them closest to her face.
Absolutely.
Do you have to adjust your makeup colors to match some colors?
You know, that's a funny question. I think it's a good question. It's an excellent question. I think that there are tones that you can adjust. You don't want to go off the whole beaten track and say you buy something orange and have a completely orange face.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe you might want to maybe warm up your lipstick a little bit too, just so it doesn't isn't jarring.
Yeah, it shouldn't be a hot pink.
Exactly.
Say
you tend towards fuchsias and pinks, but you want to try the curry. You're not going to necessarily want to wear the cool blue pinks. You might want to take it into a more coral tone to make it blend with the curry.
Interesting. Okay, we're going to select a brand new lucky number, so why not stand by and see if there's a lucky number from Sarah.
Operation, see it live! It's fast and furious, triumphant and thrilling. It's action and reaction, strong, strange, wild, wonderful. It's family and friends. It's hot. It's cool. It's the ultimate in sports entertainment.
You know, folks, the only way you can feel that excitement, that you where you can cut it with a knife, is to be at your local arena, your Coliseum, or whatever, and partake of the World Wrestling Federation. True or false, Brain?
Well, that's true. There's nothing like being there. You know, it's nice to watch on TV, and it's you can sit around the house all you want in your shorts, but that don't mean anything. It's like getting to that event. And if you want to sit in your shorts at the event, you can
Will
do that,
Will you
too.
Stop well, with yeah. the shorts? What are you preoccupied
you can sit
with
in somebody
shorts?
Somebody else's shorts if you want, then. I don't care. You can, five people can sit in the Boss Man's Mom shorts.
Feature time here this week
five
on Primetime Wrestling.
People.
Superfly Jimmy Snuka taking on Boris Zukov.
And bring a friend.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. about to enter the ring, hailing from the
Burly
Soviet
Russian
Union.
Boris Zhukov about to arrive on the scene. Oh, there he is. Nice close-up look, Boris waving the Russian flag. Zhukov. As you can see, proudly waving behind it, the American flag.
And his opponent from the
big Russian is suddenly opposed to encounter inside that ring. He may be a little bump.
How about this one on the way to the ring? The Superfly, Jimmy Snuka.
And everybody on their feet standing for this brilliant athlete as he enters the arena. What an eagle eye he has, too.
Patented signal there, I love you, the three fingers. And everyone here in the crowd sending back the same to the Superfly. Good matchup here, Lord Alfred.